Good afternoon, Lourdes. This training program created by the federal government in the wake of the Sandy Hook massacre in 2012, investigators in the aftermath determining that many lives could have been saved if teachers and administrators had had the benefit of basic first aid training.
Keep going. Two hands. Good job.
The average adult only has about a gallon and a half of blood in their body, doctors say, and it doesn't take long to lose that life-giving fluid after a traumatic injury.
You can bleed out massive amounts from some type of injury, from a motorcycle crash, shooting, car accident, even falling on a skateboard or bicycle.
I cinch it down as much as I can.
Dr. James Daugherty is a trauma surgeon at Advocate Christ Medical Center in Oak Lawn, one of the busiest level one trauma units in Illinois. He and trauma center nurses and technicians leading today's training session in the Brother Rice Gymnasium.
And we know now from experience with the military as well as civilian trauma practice that the earlier you can get hemorrhage control, limit that amount of blood loss, the better the patients do.
Among the students getting training here is Jack Lausch.
And I think if everyone has kind of at least a little bit of a general knowledge about how to do it, then I just think people, like the whole community, will be healthier, and I think we'll save some lives.
You don't want to panic in these situations. You want to know that you know what to do.
Patrick Joseph Gallagher knows a little bit about life saving. He's the son and grandson of Chicago firefighter paramedics, and he's glad to see his comrades at Brother Rice High School receiving the life saving training.
You could save someone else's lives, but you can also save your own.
You can find out about training being offered in your community. Just log on to our website for a link to services. At Brother Rice High School on the south side of Chicago, Julian Cruz, WGN News. Julian.